Hi everyone, Monisha here. This is the last episode of Human Eye, that is part 3 section, where I will be covering atmospheric refraction, scattering of light, which includes why the flickering of stars takes place, and the color due to sunrise and sunset, Tyndall effect, and all other important basic phenomena of refraction of light in the atmosphere. I hope this session will be interesting for you. Let us start the session. The apparent random wavering or flickering of objects seen through a turbulent stream of hot air rising above a fire or a radiator. The air just above the fire becomes hotter than the air further up. The hotter air is lighter, that is less dense than the cooler air above it, and has a refractive index slightly less than that of the cooler air. Since the physical condition of the refracting medium, that is air, are not stationary, the apparent position of the object as seen through the hot air fluctuates. This wavering is thus an effect of atmospheric refraction, that is, refraction of light by the Earth's atmosphere on a small scale in our environment. The twinkling of stars is a similar phenomenon on a much larger scale. For example, an object coming from other side of the fire looks like it's fluctuating. This is because of atmospheric refraction. For example, a vehicle coming in front of us from far away in a mid-hot summer day appears to be fluctuating from opposite side by the hot air on the main road. So this is flickering of an object because of refraction of light. This is the notes or the explanation on atmospheric refraction, which I have already explained in my previous slide. Refraction of light by Earth's atmosphere is called as atmospheric refraction. If the refraction takes place in the atmosphere, then it is called as atmospheric refraction. So by this, the flickering of the objects above the fire takes place. This is one of the basic examples of atmospheric refraction. Why? The apparent random wavering or flickering of objects can be seen through a turbulent stream of hot air rising above the fire. Above the fire, we can see this flickering of objects if we see through the fire. The air just above the fire becomes hotter than the further up. The air which is just above the fire is much hotter than the air which is even above it. The hotter air is lighter than the cooler air above it. So the hotter air which is just above the fire is very much lighter, means very much less denser than the cooler air above it, and has a refractive index slightly less than that of the cooler air. So by this we can understand the very much hotter air, the high density cooler air, and the less density hotter air. So hot air has less density and less refractive index, whereas the cooler air has high density and high refractive index. Since the physical condition of the refracting medium are not stationary, the apparent position of the object as seen through the hot air fluctuates. This wavering is therefore due to an effect of atmospheric refraction on a small scale in a local environment. Night sky is very beautiful. It consists of different objects. Some of them are stars and the others are planets. Looking at the night sky, can you figure out whether you are looking at stars or planets? Yes, you have been learning it from your childhood. The object which twinkles are stars and the object which do not twinkle are planets. The question in today's discussion is, why do stars twinkle? So why do stars twinkle exactly? Basically, the reason behind this twinkling of stars is atmospheric refraction. Let's learn how it happens. We live on planet Earth. The atmosphere of the Earth consists of layers of air. The particles of air are closely spaced at the surface of the Earth than they are at higher layers. That means the density of air is highest at the surface while it goes on decreasing at the top layer. Now, let's talk about a star. A star has its own light since they are at far distance from the Earth, and therefore it looks point-sized and so we can treat it as point source of light. The light coming from star, that is a starlight, will enter the Earth's atmosphere layer by layer. It experiences increase in density and so bend towards the normal at the boundaries between the layers. When it comes to us, we observe this star to be slightly higher than its actual position. Now, air has a property to flow. So there are continuous and random variations in every layer of the atmosphere. These changes result in the random changes in the refractive index of the layers. So, if refractive indices of these layers are not steady, how will the apparent position of the star appear steady? The apparent position of changes slightly but randomly, similarly because of random changes in refractive indices. The brightness of the light coming from the star also appears changing. The resulting effect of changing apparent position and changing brightness causes star to twinkle. Next is, that is, a star is twinkling because of this apparent change. The next is, why do planets do not twinkle? The reason is simple. The planet is much closer to Earth. They reflect light falling on them towards us. Since planets are much closer to Earth, they couldn't be considered as point sources. Large number of rays coming from those objects undergo refraction in random manner. But while reaching at observer, they nullify each other effect. That means neither the position of the planet changes nor there is a change in brightness of the light coming from them. The intensity of incoming light doesn't change. It remains constant and so the planets don't twinkle. I hope you understood this. Let us learn about advanced sunrise and delayed sunset. We can get to see sunrise even before sun actually rises. So now we can see the layers of the atmosphere above the Earth. The optical density decreases as it moves away from the Earth's atmosphere, that is with increasing height. So what happens is, just before actual sunrise, before the sun reaches the horizon, the sunlight enters obliquely into the atmosphere. It gets refracted through the different layers of atmosphere. Now, this refraction causes the light rays to bend. So the sunlight actually reaches the Earth's surface in a curved path. Now, what happens to the point of view of the observer? Following the path of light rays entering the eyes, the observer finds the position of the sun to be slightly above the actual position of the sun. Because of that, we see sun 2 minutes before the actual sunrise and 2 minutes after the actual sunset. Scattering of light. In this module, you will learn about the scattering of light and its effects. Sunlight is all around us, but we cannot see its rays everywhere. We can see the rays of sunlight clearly when the sunlight enters the dusty room. Do you know why this happens in the dusty room? This is due to scattering of light by the dust particles present in the dusty room. Small solid particles or dust particles suspended in the fluid or air are known as colloidal particles. The phenomenon of scattering of light by the colloidal particles is known as Tyndall effect. The same effect can be observed when sunlight passes through the trees in the canopy of dense forest. Here, tiny water droplets in the mist scatter the light. Let us do an activity to observe Tyndall effect. To this experiment, place a strong source S of a white light at the focus of a converging lens L1. This lens provides a parallel beam of light. Allow this light to pass through a transparent glass tank T containing clear water. Next, allow the beam of light to pass through a circular hole C made in a cardboard and obtain a sharp image of a circular hole on the screen MN using a second converging lens L2. As you can see, the path of the beam of light passing through the clear water, that is true solution, is not visible. Next, dissolve about 200 gram of sodium thiosulfate, that is hypo, in a clean water in a tank, and add about 1 to 2 ml of concentrated sulfuric acid to the water. What do you observe? The path of the light becomes visible through this colloidal solution. It is about 2 to 3 minutes, you will find fine microscopic sulfur particles precipitating. As the sulfur particles begin to form, you can observe blue light from the three sides of the glass tank. When viewed from the fourth side of the glass tank, facing the circular hole at first, an orange-red color and then a bright crimson-red color are observed on the screen. This happens due to scattering of light by minute colloidal sulfur particles, that is the Tyndall effect. The Tyndall effect can also be observed in the atmosphere and can explain some wonderful phenomena of nature, such as white color of the clouds, the blue color of the sky, and the reddening of the sun at sunrise and sunset. The Earth's atmosphere is a mixture of minute particles. These particles include smoke, tiny particles, water droplets, suspended particles of dust, and air molecules. When sunlight strikes these particles, it gets scattered by the particles and the scattered light reaches us. The particles scatter a particular color of the scattered light, and the color of the light that gets scattered is the color of the light we see. Let us now understand what makes the cloud appear white. The cloud consists of large water and icy particles. The large particles scatter the seven constant colors of sunlight, that is Vibhyor, equally. Thus, the light we see is a combination of all the color, that is the white light. This gives white appearance of the cloud. Let us now come to know about the blue color of the sky. The molecules of air and other fine particles in the atmosphere are very small size. They are very effective in scattering of light of shorter wavelength, that is blue light. Thus, when sunlight passes through the atmosphere, the fine particles in the atmosphere scatter the blue color of shorter wavelength more strongly than the red color of longer wavelength. The scattered blue light enters our eyes, due to which we can see blue color of the sky. Let us now try to understand how scattering of light makes sun appears red at sunrise and sunset. At the time of sunrise or sunset, the sun is near the horizon. The light from the sun near the horizon passes through a large distance in the Earth's atmosphere before reaching our eyes. While traveling through this large distance, the blue light scatters away in all the directions before reaching our eyes. Thus, at the time of sunrise or sunset, the light that reaches our eyes is of longer wavelength, that is red, and the sun appears red in color. It will be very interesting to know that if the Earth had no atmosphere, there would not be any scattering, then the sky would have looked darker. It will be scary, right? Let us have a quick recap. The path of light becomes clearly visible due to scattering of light by colloidal particles present in the path. The phenomenon of scattering of light by colloidal particles is known as Tyndall effect. The Tyndall effect can explain some wonderful phenomena of nature, such as white color of the clouds, blue color of the sky, and reddening of sun at sunrise and sunset. When sunlight strikes the minute particles present in the atmosphere, it gets scattered by the particles. The particles scatter a particular color of sunlight that we see. Let us have a quick recap on Tyndall effect. As per scattering of light. Here I will be doing a small experiment to show you how the scattering of light takes place and how we can see the beam of light. Here the laser light passes through two glass of water, clear water, and the image of it will falls on the screen like a small dot. You can see here in the two glass of water there is a clear white water. Now I will add a drop of milk and I will stir it with using a spoon. Now you can clearly observe that the ray of light is visible. So the ray of light is visible because of the scattering of particle in the second light because of the milk particles. So this shows Tyndall effect, whereas in the first we can clearly see there is no particles.